Now welcome to the next lecture in the subject where we are starting with the new theme of Fourier transform. I will try my level best to elaborate the contents of this very fundamental module. It is in general useful for you in all the subjects in future. It is as regards to general mathematical background for an engineer, the Fourier transform happens to be the foundation stone. And as I had already stated that the contents are otherwise available for students, so it is not that I am adding something new which is not available to the students, but what I will try my level best to explain it in such a simple manner so that everybody should understand it to a substantially satisfactory level. So before then, now if we say that classically you will find that what is Fourier transform, if ft is a given signal, then it gets transformed into f of omega. Now there are various notations. Some people say f of e raised to j omega is also said, or there are other conventions. Some few say f of j omega like that, but we will not adopt these conventions. The conventions which we adopt is f of t transformed to f of omega, and the formula for f of omega is very simple: integration from minus infinity to infinity f t e raised to minus j omega t and dt, and then various properties of Fourier transform, the conditions under which it exists, its inverse transform and its application is a very straightforward classical discussion. But as I can perceive from my days in the studenthood, forming years and experience for these many years of teaching the students, I think that such classical discussion is of no use. It does not have any meaningful impact on the students. Therefore, I don't deal with this formula directly. Instead, I will explain to you in very, very simple form, right from the fundamentals. So, we discussed before going for Fourier transform, we go for the very definition of what do we mean by transform. The vernacular translation of the word transform is rupantar. Rupantar. It changes the form. So we have got a function f of t. We can say y is equal to f of t, where t is an independent variable and y is a dependent variable, and it can be any function. It can exist for entire t. If it exists for some finite time, then we can draw it graphically. If it exists for infinite time, then we can't draw it, because if we decide to draw, our life will be exhausted in drawing the function. So if it is of infinite length, then we have to have a formula for it. One more thing is that, as we discussed, the function can be either one dimensional or two dimensional. Means a point moving on a whiteboard, a student with a laser gun just changes his hand so that the point moves continuously. So the input function can be two dimensional also. We can think with one dimension if it suits for us in the beginning and then later expand, or we can think from two dimensions first and then we can come to one dimension. It is up to us how we interpret it. But in general, we can say that given signal, that is the very word of the word signal, which is present in the name of the subject itself, signals and systems. So it's a given signal y is equal to ft. Say for example, y is equal to t square, y is equal to cos t, y is equal to e raised to jt. What does it mean then? It is cos t plus j sin t. So this is one dimensional signal, this is one dimensional signal, this is a two dimensional signal. So these are various signals, various input given functions with us. Now we transform the signal. What is signal? Signal is mapping of, means we plot ft or t on x-axis, horizontal axis, and ft on vertical axis if it is one dimensional function. If it is two dimensional function, we can't have a plot like this. In that case, for two dimensional function, we have to separate. What is a two dimensional function? Two dimensional function is nothing but an ordered pair of two one dimensional functions. In that case, we have to plot real part separately, imaginary part separately. So when we have function, independent variable is t on one axis and dependent variable on the other axis. So for every t, there is some ft. For every, if t is equal to y is equal to 4. Here if t is equal to 0, y is equal to 1. Here if t is equal to 0, then y is equal to 1. Here if t is equal to pi by 2, then y is equal to 0 plus j 1, that is j. So for every value of t, there is some ft. So what is signal? I again repeat, because these are the, few may say, why I am repeating simple things? Because I want to have a lasting impact of all the discussion on transforms on you. So signal is mapping of dependent variable with independent variable. So for every t, there is ft. Now what is transform? Now in, I am trying my level best to explain it in simple words. Sometimes if we apply the parameters of some classical definitions, then my description may be wrong. But I am not caring for the correctness in classical sense. What I focus, what I stress is understanding. So from that point of view, what is, what, when I transform, I am transforming the function of t or function over t into another function. So what I have ft, and it is some formula of t. We don't entertain random function. So some deterministic function, some formula, not of t, some formula consisting t. So, as say if t is equal to, we can have e raised to minus t, or e raised to minus t ut. What is ut? Ut is a function equal to 1 for t greater than equal to 0, equal to 0 elsewhere. So what this function would be? This function would be like this. 1 at t equal to 0 and asymptotically decreasing. Like this. Or we can have ft is equal to e raised to minus t square. Various ways are there, but in general, the given function, what we are not discussing random functions. Random function means, so this is a random function. We can say t, ft, no formula, you need to have a graph, you need to actually draw the function. It is possible if it is for finite length. If you have infinite length, then you can't draw a complete function, you can't You can't specify the function itself because it is for infinite length. You have to run infinitely for whole of your life to define the function. So that's not the issue. So what, for our practical purpose discussion, we say that the FT is a formula. So the given signal, given function is a formula which contains independent variable, and as of now our independent variable is of one dimension, real variable. Let us restrict the discussion for simplicity. So what a function means, some formula consisting of the independent real variable, say t. So f of t is a function, we say, of t, or there is some function of t is a meaningful sentence. It is not that it is wrong sentence, but in the classical terms, in scientific language, it is said that why it is so, there are no answers for everyone. There are some precedence, some kind of presumptions. So it is said that FT is a function over T. Means it is a formula consisting T. Now what we mean by transform? It's transform means something which I am very simple in my language, very simple in construction of language, very simple in explanation of terms. Something which, rather than explaining what a transform means, sometimes while specifying rules of what should be, it is better to specify what it should not be. Nowadays in a pandemic situation, we find that we are having excellent results, but prior to that, maybe a few years back in engineering, what was said? Not now, few decades back rather, engineering, what were the rules of the university, which was said to be good rules by the students? Say, it was said that to move to next year, students should not fail in more than 3 subjects. So then you were saying, so why you are saying that rule you are including of failure? But it was a style. So what I say, it is one way to take in. Now while telling you, when I transform FT into something, instead of telling what I should be transforming into, I am explaining it what the transform should not contain. Just like in engineering, the passing rules were, then you say that why you call it passing rules, it is failing rule. That the passing rules were, to move from first year to second year, students should not have failed in more than 3 heads of passing. So up to 3 heads it was allowed. So like that, what is transform? If t is a function, when I transform it, the transformed thing should not contain t. That is important. Should not contain t, that is a transform. When FT, you transform it into something, transforming it into something, that question mark, but instead of telling what question mark should be, I am telling what question mark should not be. Then okay, can you tell me some transform which satisfies my restriction? Since it's not an interactive class, you can put a pause, think on your own, and then listen. Then put a pause now, and when your thinking is over, you can resume. Then a student will say, yes sir, you have asked a a nice question and I will answer intelligently. I am transforming this ft into some other function f of p such that I will put t equal to p. So if p does not contain t, a function f t is transformed a function of one real variable t is transformed into a another function to indicate, I will put it capital F, convention, not a, no rule, just convention to indicate it is in transformed domain. In normal domain, the functions are the words of function, letters of function F, say G are with small letters, and in transformed domain they are capital letters. So I am transformed, I am inventing, I am devising, I am suggesting, I am proposing a new transform, that ft is transformed into fp. How, what is the method of transform? What is the formula with which you transform? It's very simple. Replace t equal to p in the formula. So that is what we can say, a trivial transform. Means you don't mean anything by that, but this is one of the way. So this should not be there. This should not be there. Then okay, it's just like in conventional examination, which you have given in the first year, up to first year, first semester, a question paper was there. Then what students do? There are few mischievous students who write question number and then write, they repeat the question as answer. Then it is wrong. Then, so what nonsense you are doing? Then some another mischievous student say, what it does? He puts it twice. So you will say that, yes, okay, I will transform with such a thing, where instead of at value of t, I will replace by 2p. So if y is equal to sin t, or if ft is equal to sin t is given function, then I will say transform would be ft is equal to sin of 2p. So this is something which is just making fun of the word transform. It's not real transform. What is to be done is, I repeat, that given function is function over t, means at every value of t, the formula of the function includes t. So ft equal to sin t, ft equal to e raised to minus t u t, ft is equal to t square, ft equal to square root of t, like that. So function includes t. Now what, when I say transform, it is not that it should not contain t, is very rude way of explaining. Now I will move to a finer way, that the given function is function over t. At various values of t, at various values of t, I have different values of the function. What I should do, I should, when I say that the transform should not contain t, what I rather mean is individual value of t should not be mattering. What I should do, I should consider the complete function over entire t and convert it into something else. Marathi sangto dilela function manje kay aahe, pratyek t la kay tari ft aahe, manje pratyek t la tya function chi value vegvegli aahe, manje t हे इंडिपेंडेंट व्हेरिएबल आहे, त्याच्या वेगवेगळ्या व्हॅल्यूजला फंक्शनची व्हॅल्यूज वेगवेगळी आहे. ट्रान्सफॉर्म म्हणजे काय? तर t च्या वेगवेगळ्या व्हॅल्यूजला जे फंक्शन वेगवेगळ्या व्हॅल्यूज देतं, ते घ्यायचं नाही, तर टीच्या वेगवेगळे व्हॅल्यूजला फंक्शनची वेगवेगळी व्हॅल्यू आहे, ती आयडेंटिटी मला पुसून टाकायची आहे. म्हणजे फंक्शनचा सर्व टी शुड डज नॉट कंटेन टी म्हणजे काय, तर फंक्शनचा सर्व टी करताचा एकत्रित विचार करायचा आहे. फंक्शनचा सर्व टी करता एकत्रित विचार करायचा आहे. आय एम विल बी गिविंग सम एक्झाम्पल. इन द लास्ट सेमिस्टर यू हॅड अपियर फॉर 6 सब्जेक्ट्स, लेट अस से 5 सब्जेक्ट्स और सम सब्जेक्ट्स प्लस ओर, इन जनरल लेट अस से 5 सब्जेक्ट्स. In each subject you got some grade. In each subject you got some grade. So if you consider individually, in each subject you have got a grade. Now if you go for CPI, cumulative performance index, in cumulative performance index what you do is based you wipe out the identity of individual subject. So individual subject marks are not seen in your cumulative performance index. So I am trying to build the concept of transform within you. Cumulative performance index is something which is not so easy. So let us say 10th. In 10th you had got 5 subjects or 6 subjects or 5 subjects of let us say 600 marks, with maths and science maybe of say 150 marks or so. Or in general you can say CBSE 5 subjects 100 marks each. So what you do, in each subject you have marks and you have a grand total. So grand total is a transformation of individual totals. So individual marks and grand total. So in grand total what we do is we merge individual identities, either grand total you can say, or grand total we divide by 5. It is average, percentage of marks. So individual subject wise marks are transformed into percentage wise marks. So it is total or average is a transformation. That was in discrete domain. You had 5 subjects. Like that here my T is continuous. My T is continuous. When my T is continuous, what I do is, instead of summation, which is a total, when what I carry for getting total, I go for integration. I am explaining you very slowly in very simple words. So if I have got FT, it is 0 before A and after B. And it is like this. Or why should I go for such odd shape? I'm trying my level best to explain it in very simple words. So FT is equal to T 0 less than 1. And equal to 0 elsewhere. So what is FT? What FT now? This is FT. 0, this is 1, this is 1. This is FT. So at every value of T, I have what? Some FT. What I can say that, why should not take equal to? I should say, let us say T by 2. So equal to doesn't give me good sense, so it's up to half. So this is FT. It is So given function tells me if t equal to t by 2 in this range, so at every value of t, I specify f t, at every individual t, I specify f t. Now, what can be a transform? The total area under the curve, that is integration, or average. So, total area is equal to base 1, height half, half of that, so is 1/4. Total area is 1/4. So, if I say that ft equal to this, it gets transformed into, I say, area 1/4. Instead of specifying ft equal to t by 2 in this range and 0 elsewhere, I say that I have a function which is having area under the curve as 1/4. So, area, that is integration actually, area under the curve. When I say area, it does not include the variable t, is a transformation. So, what I say area, define area, I can simply define a formula. I need not take this example also, it can be in general as such. So, what is area under a curve? Area under a curve is defined by, very simple, we don't go into those details right now, y integration and so, but I think everybody is knowing, or at least in science pseudo knowledge, that if t minus infinity to infinity, if t dt gives me area under the curve. Area under the curve. For example, I give you one function. Ft is equal to e raised to minus t ut. If it is so, then what that would be? Since ut is there, it is first to from 0 to infinity. E raised to minus t. So what that would be? It would be e raised to minus t upon minus 1, 0 to infinity. That would be equal to, at infinity it would be 0, overall minus, at 0 it is 1, upon minus 1, so that is 1. So this curve is having area of 1. So the answer would be 1. So a function e raised to minus t ut is transformed into area. So finding area under the curve is another way of transformation. But what is the major problem? That this transformation is not 1-to-1. I will explain. Suppose if you ask a student, you want some candidate for some kind of Marathi literature study. Then if you ask him, what is the SSC percentage? He will say, my SSC percentage is 90%. Based on that, you will find that yes, it's okay. But will it be possible for you to conclude whether it is useful for you? No, because total or average is a transformation which completely wipes out individual marks. So that also we don't want. We also don't want such complete wiping out. Because when these are completely wiped out, that identity is lost. So when that identity is lost, that can't be retrieved. So for a given mark sheet consisting of individual marks, it will lead to same total, it will lead to a unique total, but its contrast is not true. Same total can be from different set of individual marks. So total is not one-to-one transform, total is many-to-one transform. Total is many-to-one transform. Means this particular student having different marks leads to this total. Another student having different marks in individual subjects will also lead to same total. So knowing this, you cannot come back here. So the individual identity of independent variable is completely wiped out. So from FT you can come to area. So area transformation is a transformation which is not reversible. Area transformation is not a reversible transform. I am trying my level best to explain how we can have various transformations. In fact, actually, sometimes we will study at the end of the semester discrete Fourier transform. It is something which can be understood because it is very simple, but for that we have to have some background, so I don't jump to that. Now I will give you some other, just some puzzle like example. Suppose if a student is there, he is tested for two subjects, one not SSC, in general linguistic aptitude, and mathematics, or not, we can say scientific aptitude. Linguistic aptitude and scientific aptitude. Now in linguistic aptitude he gets 80 marks, in scientific aptitude he gets 90 marks. Then if you these have total to 170 total and average, so when you specify average, individual identity is completely lost. Now what you do is, similarly you can have difference, or it is just one way. So we forget average and we say total is one thing, and other is difference, in which you subtract 80 minus 90, that is minus 10. Difference is minus 10. So it is just like coding, some kind of secret coding like that. So you don't tell 80 and 90 directly, but you tell 170 and minus 10, where what 170 is, it is A plus B, and minus 10 is A minus B. So sum and difference. So instead of telling A and B, sum and difference. instead of directly disclosing individual identity of linguistic and scientific aptitudes, you tell it in some other form where it is not directly visible. So I just now change my, not change, I refine my statement. So when we are having a function of t to be transformed into something else, when I say, when I turn now, when if t is to be transformed into ft, which is some formula over a real variable t, is to be transformed into another function. Another function, which I say of some other variable of omega, which is a formula over other variable omega, in such a manner, in I am trying my level best. I expect you to think over in a non-trivial way. Manner means what? Non-trivial. Otherwise, you will say in non-trivial manner means function over t is to be transformed into function over omega. By that, you can make my fun. If I ask you this, if I ask you to do this, then you can make my fun easily just by putting t equal in given function, putting t equal to omega. This is something which you are making fun, so it should not be such casual. So it should not. In non-trivial manner, then you say, no, yes, sir. You said that t should not be equal to omega, then I will put t equal to 2 omega. Somebody will say, I will put t equal to omega, t equal to omega square. So, what non-trivial manner means what? What is indication that I am meaning some, I am going for some serious transformation? Non-trivial manner means what? There should not be. Not be a direct relationship between t and omega. Marathi shabd t he ek real variable ahe ki je minus infinity to infinity asu shakta, tyacha ft he ek function ahe. त्याचे एफ टी हे एक फंक्शन आहे. तर मला एफ टी ट्रान्सफॉर्म करायचं आहे. आय सेड अर्लियर इट इज एव्हरेज, बट इन दॅट केस फ्रॉम एव्हरेज आय कांट गेट द फंक्शन बॅक, सो दॅट इज नॉट सो इफेक्टिव्ह ट्रान्सफॉर्मेशन. आता ट्रान्सफॉर्म मला काय करायचं आहे, दिलेल्या फंक्शन एफ टी, एफ ऑफ स्मॉल एफ ब्रॅकेट टी स, मला दुसऱ्या एका फंक्शन मध्ये ट्रान्सफॉर्म करायचं कॅपिटल एफ ब्रॅकेट ओमेगा. ही ओमेगा सुद्धा रिअल व्हेरिएबल आहे. मग ते मी गमतीनं करीन, टी इक्वल टू ओमेगा, टी इक्वल टू ओमेगा, तसं नाही करायचं. मला मिनिंगफुल करायचंय, नॉन ट्रिव्हियल, असं किरकोळ मध्ये नसलेलं ट्रान्सफॉर्मेशन. फॉर वेन दॅट इज पॉसिबल, की टी अँड ओमेगा मध्ये काही रिलेशन असतं का? मीन्स देर शुड नॉट बी एनी फॉर्म्युला बिटवीन टी अँड ओमेगा. टी अँड ओमेगा मध्ये फॉर्म्युला टाकलं तर ते कॅज्युअल ट्रान्सफॉर्मेशन, दॅट आय डोंट. So such that, what is my condition now? Such that from ft I should be able to, given ft I should be able to obtain f omega. Listen very carefully. I am trying my level best to explain it to the simplest manner. From given ft, I should be able to find f omega. Similarly, from f omega, I should be able to obtain ft back. So it should be invertible. So what I and not such funny transformation. So not casual transformation means t and omega both are independent real variables with no relation with each other. What I should and while transforming ft into f omega, when I look at f omega, the individual identity of t should not be directly reflected. So I carry out some kind of mathematical changes, some kind of process by which I take all values of t while finding f omega for given omega. I take all values of t together. I give again simple example. When I have linguistic and scientific marks as 80 and 70, while preparing sum, I take both values, I add them. And while preparing difference, again I take both values and I subtract them. So while preparing sum, I treat these two in some I take this in some different way. While preparing difference, I take it in some different way. Similarly, what I should have is, when I compute f omega from ft, what is needed is, while computing f omega for given omega, individual identity of ft should not be getting exhibited. Means I should consider values of ft for all t's at once. So I have to have an integration of ft dt. But if it is simple, this integration, in that case what I will get, I will get a single value. So from ft I will be able to get this area, but from area I can get ft back. Therefore, if ever I have to obtain f omega from ft and similarly ft from f omega, in that case this direct average totaling is not allowed. So this is integration, is direct integration resulting into area under the curve. Instead of that, I should have a weighted integration. So what I should do, why integration is needed? Because I should be considering values of all t's at once, so that when I integrate with dt and I find the things, in the final answer t is not there. So what I should do is, to this ft I should multiply by some other function which should include t and omega together. So what I say, minus infinity to infinity ft, I say other function g of omega or t and omega together. So what I am doing, this is very carefully. So only if t dt minus infinity to infinity f t dt is area under the given curve. Is area f t is a function. Integration f t dt from minus infinity to infinity is area under the given function. Now, what I am intending, instead of area under the given function, what I am doing is, I am multiplying the function by other weight function. This is weight function. Ft g of t omega. So for given omega, it is t is a variable and omega is a parameter. Means what is referring to omega is a constant. For given omega can change. For given omega, g t of omega becomes function of time. So if t is given function, I am multiplying it by another function of time and I am finding out area under the product of these two functions. Original function, just like we have got a sum and a weighted sum. The concept is sum and weighted sum. When we have weighted sum, we multiply each term by some weight. So this is area under the given function. This is area under another function, which is nothing but a multiplication of given function into weight function. For given omega, this is function over time. So when I do this, in that case, it becomes, so what I am doing, I am taking the area of under the weighted curve, weighted original function. If ft I say is a curve, ft dt minus infinity to infinity is area under the curve. Whereas ft another function, that is weight function, dt minus infinity to infinity is area under the weighted curve. Now, what this should be, g of t omega is a, it should be a composite function. Composite function means which is a function of t and omega together. T and omega together with t and omega not separable. Say for example, I can say cos t cos omega is not a function, because if cos t cos omega is there, then for this integration, omega being constant, this will come out. And when this comes out, it would be simply then a integration of ft cos t dt. Ft cos t dt, and it will not be a reversible transformation then. So it should be composite function. So what kind of composite function it can be, students can think over it, such that now what are the requirements of the function. So composite function means it should not be a product with from which part of omega and part of t are separable. That should not be there. So then, for example, what are the different functions? So let us say, just I am giving you an example. Cos omega t, yes. Cos omega t is a composite function. Means cos omega t, you can't separate out the term of omega from it. So cos omega t will remain, means it, omega t will always remain omega t. So this can be good function. So what we can say is that f omega is equal to f t cos omega t dt. It is one transformation, one good transformation, and it is, since it is cos, I will say it is cosine transform. So Fourier transformation we will discuss later. So what I somehow thought to introduce, it can be a good starting point. So don't go for Fourier transform instantly. We can simply say it is a cosine transform. So cosine transform. Similarly, there is ample opportunity for everybody to think and come up with your own transform. Maybe somebody from your class come up with a transform as strong as Fourier, and that may be a new transform, just like say Wavelet transform came later, Hilbert transform, and so on. So this is a cosine transform. So what is cosine transform? F t is transformed into f c omega such that f c omega is equal to minus infinity to infinity, minus infinity to infinity, f t cos omega t dt. F t cos omega t dt. This is cosine transform with a formula. Now we are coming to end of this introductory session with some questions which I am expecting you to be ready before coming listening to the next lecture. Now the question is whether this transformation is invertible. There are a few more questions. Whether the transform exists for all functions f t. Number one. So I raise few questions. Well, this is a cosine transform. Number question one. Whether for all FTs this transform exists is one question. Number one. Under what condition it exists? If it exists for all, then no issues. Otherwise, it may exist for some conditions. If it exists, then is it invertible?